Hello everyone and welcome. There are two ways you can install your Python packages in your PyCharm IDE. The first method is to go to your terminal. If you look down, you will see terminal and then you select terminal. When I click on it, a small window opens here. So here you can use your pip to install any package that you want to use in your project. So let's assume I want to install pandas. So I can say pip install pandas. And then I hit enter. And you see it's all installing in this project. I could try another one and say pip. Okay, it's still installing before I go to the next one. So it has finished installing. I could try another one and say pip install Pygame. And I hit enter. And that way you have successfully installed these two packages. The second method is the best to use, because JetBrain has made it a lot easier for us by creating a hub with a list of common Python packages. So to do that, you go to your file and then you go to setting. If you're on Windows, if you're on Mac, you go to preference and then you come to your Python interpreter. So if you see here, these are a list of the packages I have installed. You see, I installed pandas using terminal and then I installed Pygame. You see, they are both here. So each time you install successfully, you see your list of packages will appear under your interpreter wizard. So to install a new set of packages, all you need to do, you come down here, you see the addition sign, you select that addition sign. If you want to remove any from your list here, you come here and select the negative sign, which is uninstall. Maybe let's try first with uninstalling. I will uninstall my Pygame. So I select Pygame. And then I uninstall it. And then let's see what happens. You see, it's trying to uninstall. And then it says, package Pygame successfully uninstalled. There is no longer Pygame on this list anymore. You could do that again for pandas. You could come here again and say, uninstall pandas. And then you see pandas was successfully uninstalled. So to install using this PyCharm list of Python packages, you go to the addition, then you select it, and then it brings you to this wizard where you have hundreds of Python packages that you can use for your project. Depending on what you want, you could just type it in and then it will give you suggestions. So let's say we want to install pandas through this means. So I type pandas and it gives me a whole list of packages related to pandas. So you can scroll down and select what you want. Here you can come and specify the version of the package you want to install. So if you want an earlier version, all you need to do is to check this box and then scroll down and select that particular version, because sometimes you could want to run a particular program and it requires you to use a lower version, then you could decide to select that lower version and install it. So, but for today, I want to use the current version. And then once you're happy with the version, then you come here and you select again. So we have our pandas checked. You come here and you select install package. And you see it's showing that it is installing. So let's wait and see it's successfully installed. So it says pandas installed successfully. We could also do it with the Pygame also. So Pygame is used for your game development in Python. So I could go Pygame. And then it gives me a list here. I make sure it's selected. And then I come here, install package. And I have my game successfully installed. I could also try one other one. I could say IAPWS, which is for properties of water and steam. Come here again, select a version if you're happy with the current version, and then I click installed. And that's how you have your packages installed. So to check if these packages were successfully installed, you close this, and then you see this appears in the list of your installed packages. We have your IAPS, we have pandas, we have Pygame. And then you can now select OK. And then you can come here to use the import function in order to use any of your installed packages. So I could say import and same thing for import IAPWS, and that's it. And once you use any of those functions, it would automatically allow you to run whatever you want to run with this, your imported packages. Maybe we can try one example here. But the caveat here is, before you use any of the packages, you should be familiar with the documentation of that package. So what that means is, you should be familiar with how that package works in terms of how you call the parameters in that package. So because I'm familiar with these packages, I will just try one of this one that I've imported here. So I will try the one for IAPS. So I will say in IAPS, we have several subfolders associated with the property of water and steam. So I want to call, say, from IAPS WS, I'll say import IA97. So it gives me an option here. And then I'm trying to find the property of steam at a particular temperature and at a particular dryness fraction. So I could say I want to look for the pressure equals IAPWS 97, and then I specify the temperature. I can set this at 400 and a dryness fraction of 1, and then I can now say print pressure dot pip. So that's the way this fluid properties work under this model. So you need to specify the pressure. And that's it. I can now run this model now. And you see I now have my value for my pressure. So you can have a go. And that's how you install Python packages in your PyCharm IDE. I hope you find this video useful. If you do, please hit the like button and subscribe to see more videos like this. Thank you. Bye for now.